98% of the folks in the forefront of that movement had a reverend in front of their name before they had a PhD. Mm-hmm. And if we keep ignoring the black church was my daddy. The black church was where I went to school. The black church was my camp. It was my Christmas. That was my Santa Claus. Lord, and then we sit around here now talking about the old days. The old days is gone. Mm. And I sit today and listen to these new stats coming out. Well, 85% of all children that drown in America today is African American. And 90% of those that drown, their mother and father can't swim. Why? Because when I grew up, you couldn't go to the white YMCA where they had a swimming pool. Huh? You couldn't go to the city swimming pool. Okay? But when you make a whole race of people invisible, I'll wear green, blue, chartreuse, and all of you to laugh at me, you have to see me. Mm. And so I came here to the church and became visible. I got me a Cadillac, man, but I park it 6 blocks from work because if white folks see it, I think I'm going to get fired. Mm. But I could bring it to church. I couldn't wear my new clothes to work. Mm. I couldn't share with them white folk that my daughter and my son is at Princeton.
Yeah, that's true. Huh? That's
but I could come to church and the preacher tell all y'all he's graduating. Back them days, if you died, you went from where you died to the undertaker. Mm. Okay? And if it wasn't for the black church, I couldn't read it in the white paper. Mm. That Mrs. Sulu is sick in Chicago and she passed. Huh? So the New York Times, my church bulletin was my New York Times.
Lord have mercy.
It told me who had been drafted. Huh? Who had made the honor roll? Huh? Who had finished college? Huh? It didn't tell me who was in jail. Huh? They ain't got no part in that damn bulletin to tell me so-and-so was murdered at a crap game. That church bulletin, that bulletin that I go and look at.
Doc.
And that's why I wanted to learn how to read so I could see what's happening in the community
Lord
on Sunday.
It was an other world, out of body experience to listen to Dick Gregory just open up.
How can I forget?
But being in that place took Dick back to his roots. Back to the church he grew up in. He could not recall at 75 years of age the last time he had been in a church. But when he stepped in there, it all came out. And it just spoke to me in a powerful way about the profundity of the black church.